how to go from here to here. So any guesses? And I guess the following problem assume that xy equals qyx. Take z equals yx and assume that q and z commute. Then you go from here to here. Now let's try to express this fraction as continued fraction as a ratio of two series. So you can do this. And then, let me define, so that for any monomial u equals x alpha 1 y 1 x alpha 2 I will put alpha u, the sum of alpha 1 plus alpha n, so and u. Now, let me define the series. Xy equals y plus xy squared plus y xy plus y squared so on. So we are taking sum of all and I will define also q xy equals 1 plus xy plus yx plus so on. So this is sum again. And applications on this commutative Lagrange theorem, or theory of quantum determinants, if you wish, gives you the answer. So the theorem says k xy is equal to p q inverse y inverse. So that's a simple. Now specialization. So let me just maybe put this k zq. And from this immediately follows that q zq is equal to sum and greater equal than zero z to the n q to the minus n plus 1 over 2. This is q binomial coefficient, and this is divided by sum two n. And of course, well, this was known to Roman and Jean, I believe. But I don't know how one can get such formulas. This one is easier. This one is easy to.
So you have a new proof of this.
Sorry?
You have a new proof of the community.
Yeah, yeah. So actually, I have derived that kx1 is, again, that's a quasi determinant of the infinite matrix, which is x, xy1, x, y1. So 1 is on the diagonal, then x is overall diagonal, y is now, this formula first appeared, and this was just actually a preprint from 1993, and this is just Mark Bosnick, and so they were just students at the time. So I don't have that much time, so what I will skip. So this is a theory of S fraction, S from Stieltjes, and J fractions, which is also an ancient story, and their relations with orthogonal polynomials, non-commutative orthogonal polynomials. This can be found, this is paper by Six also, and this is 1994. I can give you exact reference of this chapter, and I will skip this. Then I want actually to formulate a question before, but I don't have that much time, but I intend to formulate, and the question, what is a non-commutative analog of the famous Gauss continuous fractions? Gauss wrote this as a famous continuous fractions. I don't write it here. I would like to know what is non-commutative analog. So that's then one can talk about what is non-commutative hypergeometric functions. But it's known what a matrix. All right, so now I will try maybe just to discuss maybe one quantitative version of our famous polynomials. And let me talk about non-commutative inversion polynomials. So let me recall, and people here know this better than I am, that so let Tm will be the set of trees with vertices. Now just a pair ij pair of vertices.
Rooted label tree.
Yeah. Rooted label tree, yes.
With the root zero.
Yeah. Now let inversion of T is the number for inversions. And one can introduce a polynomial, again that's a classical stuff, sum, q, t, well again from this famous. Now one can actually interpret those polynomials differently, and they are interpreted through so-called wraparound sequences. And so they are, so suppose you have sequence of natural numbers, A1, A2, N, and the sequence is like that. If so, I will write it formally. And so, fortunately, no time to comment on this, but this is actually also famous, I believe, definition. Now, for any such sequence, or any have 2 minutes to define what is non-commutative version of So again, let x, y will be free variables. I will define for any Majorana sequence this number. And then I define the polynomial of two variables as sum over all natural sequences x m 1 a y x m 2 a x Well, again, a specialization, if you have this specialization, and yx, and z is equal to yx, then I and xy is equal just to marginal. This polynomial is again. Okay, and now I will finish with the writing just the formula for generating functions for and the theorem says if you take sum over n y, then this is p q inverse and p just sum n one and they are all positive. 1 and 1 factorial, and k factorial, x, m1, y, x, m2, y. And q is, well, sum. Equals k, also all the same. I get this name, sorry, this from k plus 1. Y, and again, you can specialize, you may specialize this by using this and get a famous formula for this. So I will stop here. The thing is that there are many problems that I could try by using, you know, some map or something. So that's all.
Thank you very much.
We'd like to answer questions in private. Thank you for coming.